It's important to manage your diabetes during cancer treatment. Radiation therapy, steroids, and some types of chemotherapy may impact your blood sugar levels. A person living with diabetes may have a problem with not making enough insulin, or the body is not able to use insulin to move sugar from the blood into the cells. Diabetes may cause high levels of sugar in the blood, leaving the cells in the body starving for energy. When blood sugar levels are higher than normal, insulin therapy may be used to bring them down quickly. Insulin unlocks the cells of the body, allowing sugar or glucose to move from the bloodstream into the cells where it's used for energy. There are various types of insulin that can be used for glucose control. The time it takes for insulin to start working, peak, and the duration may vary for each person. Your care team will decide on the types and schedule of insulin based on personalized factors, including the cause of diabetes, the medicines you are currently taking, such as steroids and/or chemo, and your diet and lifestyle. If you have any changes in these factors, contact your doctor right away to make sure you have good control of your diabetes. It's common to need two types of insulin: a long, intermediate-acting insulin to control the sugar produced by the body, and a rapid or short-acting insulin to control the sugar received from the food you eat. Rapid and short-acting insulins are often given at mealtimes with doses adjusted based on blood sugar levels and the amount of carbohydrates in your meal. The red curve on this graph represents the rapid and short-acting insulin. This dose may be referred to as a bolus, with a quick onset and shorter duration. The bolus doses are often increased during cancer treatment with steroids. Intermediate and long-acting insulins are often given in one or two divided doses per day. The green curve shows this type of insulin. These doses may be referred to as basal insulin and have a slower onset and longer duration. The basal doses are often adjusted based on what happens to the sugar levels when fasting or delaying a meal. Unopened, unused insulin vials and pens should be kept refrigerated at 36 to 46 degrees Fahrenheit, or 2 to 8 degrees Celsius, and protected from light. Refrigerated, unopened insulin vials and pens may be used until the expiration date. If unopened, unused insulin vials and pens are kept at room temperature, they must be thrown away after 1 month. This is the case for most brands. However, refer to your insulin package insert for details. Never freeze insulin. If insulin has been frozen, throw it away and do not use. Store insulin vials and pens that are open and being used at room temperature, not to exceed 86 degrees Fahrenheit or 30 degrees Celsius. Talk with your diabetes care team about insulin if you have any questions.